So children, till now we have seen that bacteria needs three conditions to grow. First is air or oxygen. Just like we need oxygen, the bacteria and fungus also need oxygen and air. So first condition is air. Second is presence of moisture or water. And third is room temperature. The temperature should neither be very high nor very low. If any one of these conditions is removed, the bacteria or fungus stops growing. So here some food items are given and some simple methods are given using which we can preserve our food. Preserve our food means protect our food from getting spoiled. Preservation means protection of food from getting spoiled. So we have to match the correct food item with the correct method. First is milk. जब भी दूध आता है तो मम्मी क्या बोलती है, उसको बॉयल करो. बॉयल क्यों करो, उबालो क्यों, इससे बैक्टीरिया मर जाए. सो मैच मिल्क विथ बॉयल इट. मिल्क विथ बॉयल इट. सेकेंड इज कुक्ड राइस. हाउ कैन वी सेव कुक्ड राइस, पुट इन अ बोल एंड कीप द बोल इन अ कंटेनर विथ सम वाटर. इन दिस वे द कुक्ड राइस कैन बी सेव्ड. ऑल राइट. थर्ड इज ग्रीन कोरिएंडर और धनिया. वी कैन सेव ग्रीन कोरिएंडर बाय रैपिंग इन अ डैम्प क्लॉथ. वी आर रैपिंग इट इन अ डैम्प क्लॉथ. डैम्प क्लॉथ मीन्स अ वेट क्लॉथ सो दैट इट स्टेज फ्रेश. द ग्रीननेस ऑफ द कोरिएंडर रिमेन्स इंटैक्ट. एंड लास्ट इज अनियन एंड गार्लिक. We should just keep it in open, dry place. I hope you understood this. Now, next, here, we are going to read about summer treat, Mami di Tundra. So, Mami di Tundra means Aam Papad in Telugu. So, this is a story of two brothers, Chitti Babu and Chinna Babu, who live in Athreyapuram town in Andhra Pradesh, and they spend their summer holidays playing in the mango garden when the trees are full of fruits. They also like to eat unripe mangoes. Unripe mangoes means kacha mango with salt and chili powder. At home, their mother cooks unripe mangoes in different ways. She also makes many kinds of mango pickles. The pickles last through the year until the next mango season. So this is why our chapter is called Mangoes Round the Year, because by making pickles we can save mangoes from getting spoiled and we can enjoy it throughout the year until the next mango season comes. One evening while having food, Chinna Babu asked, Amma, we have so many mangoes. Make some Mami di Tundra Aam Papad from them. Their father said making Mami di Tundra needs 4 weeks of hard work. So how many weeks does it take to make Mami di Tundra? 4 weeks of hard work. A lot of hard work is needed. If you both promise to help us every day for the next 4 months, we can together make the Mami di Tundra. Both the brothers quickly agreed to help. See, such nice brothers, they are helping their parents to make food, to make Mami di Tundra or Aam Papad. You should also help your parents in everyday chores. The next day, both the children went to the market with their father. They bought a mat woven from the leaves of a palm tree, poles of casuarina tree, string made of coconut husk. What is coconut husk? It is the rough outer brown part. So a string, patli si, rassi made up of coconut husk. Some jaggery, jaggery means gurd and sugar. Amma found a sunny place in the backyard. Both the brothers made a high platform by using poles. They spread out and tied the mat on the platform. So look at this picture. This is a platform and they have used the coconut husk strings to tie the mat with the poles of the casuarina tree. And then what are they going to do the next day? Appa chose the most ripe mangoes. जो सबसे पके मैंगोज थे वो अप्पा ने चूज करे. दे टुक आउट द मैंगो पल्प इन टू अ लार्ज पॉट. पल्प मीन्स द सॉफ्ट पार्ट, द इनसाइड सॉफ्ट पार्ट ऑफ द मैंगो. देन दे स्ट्रेन्ड द पल्प थ्रू अ फाइन मसलिन क्लॉथ. स्ट्रेन्ड द पल्प मीन्स उन्होंने उसको छाना थ्रू अ फाइन मसलिन क्लॉथ. बहुत पतला सा कॉटन क्लॉथ, उसको बोलते हैं मसलिन क्लॉथ. उससे उस कॉटन क्लॉथ से उन्होंने मैंगो पल्प को छाना टू रिमूव द फाइबर्स फ्रॉम द पल्प. सो पूरा जूस उन्होंने उसको निकाल लिया, छान लिया. देन चिट्टी बाबू क्रश्ड द गुड़ टिल देयर वर नो लम्प्स. दे एडेड द जैगरी एंड शुगर इन इक्वल अमाउंट्स टू द पल्प. तो अब उन्होंने उसको पल्प में बहुत सारा चीनी और गुड़ डाला. अब हम आगे देखेंगे ऐसा क्यों किया. चिन्ना बाबू मिक्स द जैगरी एंड शुगर वेल विद अ बिग स्पून. अम्मा देन स्प्रेड द पल्प इनटू अ थिन लेयर ओवर द मैट. द थिन लेयर वाज लेफ्ट टू ड्राई इन द सन. इन द इवनिंग दे कवर्ड द मैट विद अ क्लीन साड़ी टू अवॉइड एनी डस्ट. सो उन्होंने मैंगो पल्प जो निकाला उसमें बहुत सारा शुगर और बहुत सारा गुड़ डाला, अच्छे से मिक्स किया और वो जो मैट उन्होंने बनाया था उस पर लेयर बना के सन में ड्राई किया. क्यों कर रहे हैं ये लोग ड्राई? ड्राई करने से क्या होगा, जो भी वाटर होगा वो हट जाएगा, है ना. और हमने अभी पढ़ा कि अगर बैक्टीरिया और फंगस को ग्रो करना है दे नीड वाटर, दे नीड मॉइस्चर. अगर सनलाइट में ड्राई करेंगे तो बैक्टीरिया ग्रो नहीं कर पाएगा. नेक्स्ट डे दे अगेन टुक आउट सम मैंगो पल्प. दे अगेन एडेड जैगरी एंड शुगर इनटू द पल्प. Then they spread the pulp over the previous day's layer. This work was given to both the brothers. Both of them together spread many layers over it. For the next 4 weeks, they hoped it would not rain. अब ये लोग बार बार उसमें शुगर मिला के, जैगरी मिला के बार बार उस लेयर के ऊपर लेयर डाल रहे हैं और सनलाइट में सुखा रहे हैं. एंड दे आर होपिंग दैट इट वुड नॉट रेन. रेन हो जाएगी तो क्या हो जाएगा, फिर से वाटर उसमें चला जाएगा. वाटर चला गया तो बैक्टीरिया ग्रो हो जाएगा. For 4 weeks, they added layer after layer until the jelly grew 4 centimeters thick. 4 centimeter thick जब वो layer हो गई और golden color की दिखने लगी, वो लोग layer पे layer add करते रहे. After some days, Amma said, "The Mamidi Tantra is ready. We can take it out and cut it into pieces tomorrow." Now, finally, after 4 weeks of hard work, the Mamidi Tantra was ready. The next day, mat was brought down from the platform. Mamidi Tantra was cut into smaller pieces. The brothers tasted it. It was tasty. Chinna Babu said, "Wow, how tasty! After all, we have also helped in making it." So together, the whole family helped in making Mamidi Tantra. So why was sugar and jaggery mixed into mango pulp and dried in the sun? Children, we can save our food by adding a lot of sugar or a lot of salt. Just like in pickles, we add a lot of salt. By adding salt, bacteria and fungus do not grow because they need those kind of conditions which are mild. But a lot of salt does not let the bacteria and fungus to grow. In the same way, when we make jams and jellies and aam papad, in this case when we add sugar and jaggery, a lot of sugar and jaggery when it is added, it does not let the bacteria to grow. So when we make jams of fruits, we are saving our fruit, we are protecting our fruit from getting spoiled by adding lot of sugar and jaggery. So now you can answer why jaggery and sugar was mixed and dried in the sun, because it won't let the bacteria to grow. Next, why did Appa first choose the most ripe mangoes to be used for making Mami Di Tundra? Appa chose the most ripe mangoes to make Mami Di Tundra because, first of all, the most ripe mangoes would be very sweet, hai na? If you take unripe mangoes, then it won't be sweet. Also, ripe mangoes have a lot of juice, more juice. So Mami Di Tundra requires mango juice to be made from. So by using ripe mangoes, it has more juice and less fiber, and which is good for making Mami Di Tundra. How did the brothers make the Mami Di Tundra? Write down step by step what they did for this. I think you can write this on your own. Write down in 5-6 steps, small steps. What things are made in your house from ripe and unripe mangoes? Many things. Like, we can make chutney. We can make pickles from unripe mangoes. And from ripe mangoes, we can make Mami Di Tundra or aam papar and mango shake. Hai na? Make a list of all the different types of pickles that you know about and share it with your friends. You can write any kind of pickles you know about. Mango pickle, lemon pickle, amla pickle, chili, jackfruit, radish, whatever pickles you make. Is there any kind of pickle made in your house? What kind of pickle is it? Who makes it? From whom did they learn to make it? No need to write this question in your copy. You can write this in your book only. So you can write whatever you have seen in your house. In my house, I have seen ginger and radish pickle and chili pickle and mango pickle. And who makes it? In my house, my grandmother makes it. And from whom did they learn? She learned from her own mother. So you can write your answer. No need to do this question in your copy. Next, what all things are needed to make any one type of pickle in your house? How is the pickle made? Find out the recipe and write. So to make pickle in our house, we need lot of salt. We need whatever that thing we require to make pickle of, such as lemon or mango, raw mango. Then we need oil, and because oil also does not let the water come in, so, and we put a lot of masala also. So again, you don't need to write this in your copy. You just need to understand that we need all these ingredients to make pickle. Red chili powder, coriander powder, turmeric, mustard seed, methi. All these things are put in a glass jar or a porcelain jar. And all these things are mixed up with the pickle, with the fruit or the vegetable that of which we want the pickle to be made, and then kept in the jar full of oil, submerged in oil. And then it is also kept in the sunlight again so that it gets dried. Find out how these things are made in your house. Papad, chutney, badiya, sauce. So papad is made up of various kind of pulses, lentils, and such as urad dal, and some masala is also mixed with them, some spices and salt. Chutney is made up of many things like coriander or even unripe mangoes, dhania mirchi chutney, and salt is added, and all these things are mixed together. Badiya is made up of उड़द दाल, उड़द ग्रेन्स एंड विच आर सोक्ड इन वाटर एंड देन ग्राउंड. सम स्पाइसेस आर ऑल्सो एडेड इन दिस एंड देन स्मॉल स्मॉल लम्ब्स आर मेड एंड दे आर ड्राइड इन द सन. They kept it on a cloth and dried in the sun. Next, sauce, like tomato sauce is made. Tomato sauce is made using salt and tomato and other kinds of things that you can add in the salt. Some sugar and salt is also added. So in this way we can make salt. This it is a 2-day journey by train from Pune to Kolkata. If you were to go on this trip, what food items would you carry with you? How would you pack them? Make a list on the blackboard of all the packed food. What food would you eat first? So if we are traveling for a long distance, we will carry those food which do not get spoiled easily. So we will carry foods which are dry, which have less water. So we can carry biscuits, chips, dry fruits, papad or rice flakes, chivda, murmure, puri, dry sabzi. And which food would you first eat? We will eat those food which has comparatively more water, such as the potato sabzi and the puri. First we will try to finish them up, because they are a little wet and they may get spoiled. What have we learned? Glass jars and bottles are dried well in the sun before filling them with pickles. Why is this done? Do you remember what happened to the bread in the experiment? Now you know why we dry anything in the sun. We dry anything in the sun so that it removes all the moisture from the bottles and the jars. And in the experiment with the bread got spoiled because of moisture and fungus. To eat mangoes round the year, we make different items like pickle, aam papad, chutney, chikki. List some other food items with which we can make different things so that we can enjoy it throughout the year. So you can make a list of food items such as murabba, made up of amla. It is also very sweet, a lot of sugar is added. We can make chips, banana chips and potato chips, so they can last long, for a long time. And pulses also, pulses are made to dry. The badiya are made by drying the pulses. Vegetables like cauliflower, they are also dried for later use. Pickles are made of different things so that we can enjoy it throughout the year. I hope you all understood this chapter, and if you have any doubt, you can ask me in the comments. Thank you.